Hello students, I welcome you all to Santukaram National Model School. These are the online sessions of 21-22 batch. I am your teacher, Mr. Sachin Suryavanshi, and we will be learning about the India's rivers in these online sessions. So let's begin. Before that, let's revise it quickly. What we have learned? We have learned the types of the rivers that, or the rivers of India gets divided into two rivers, or you may say the two types, major types, that is the Himalayan rivers and peninsular rivers. After that, we have also seen the difference between non-perennial rivers and perennial rivers. Now, the Himalayan rivers, the three main basins are there. We have already learned the Indus River system and Ganga River system in our previous videos. You can go and watch on our channel. Now, in today's session, we will be learning about the Brahmaputra River, which is the main river of the Northeast India, you can say. Right. So, let's start the Brahmaputra River system. Brahmaputra River rises in Tibet and it rises towards the little east side of the Mansarovar Lake. At the same place, you are having the sources of Indus and Satluj River, that is near the Mansarovar Lake. But the Indus and Satluj rivers rises on the west side of Mansarovar Lake, whereas the Brahmaputra River rises towards the east side of Mansarovar Lake. In Tibet, it flows mostly through the Tibet area. In Tibet, it is known as Tsangpo. It is known by the name Tsangpo River. It is slightly longer than the Indus River and it is the most peak also, you may say, and most of its course lies in the Tibet area. It flows eastwards parallel to the Himalayas or the Himalayan mountains, and near the Namcha Barwa, it takes a U-turn and it enters in India first in the state of Arunachal Pradesh through a gorge. Here it is called as Dihang and it is joined by Dibang, Lohit and Kenula and numerous other small tributaries to form the mighty big Brahmaputra River in Assam. The Tsangpo River, or in Tibet, the Tsangpo River carries a smaller volume of water and less silt. But when it enters in the Indian mountains, or you may say when it enters, it crosses the northern mountains, it enters in India, it carries out a lot of silt and soil, and hence it deposits that soil by making the Sundarban area there.